Crop News, brought to you by the Kansas Association of Wheat Growers and Kansas Wheat Commission. Together, we are Kansas Wheat.
This morning, what a great day. I mean, we picked a perfect morning to come
out here. Absolutely.
Okay, so we need to make sure everybody understands you don't just show up in a field and start counting soybeans.
Oh, absolutely not. The first thing I do is this field has been randomly selected. I need to contact the operator and get his permission as to whether he would be okay with me going take a look at it. We also discuss what variety of beans are in this field. At the end, just before harvest, we even take a sample of beans and send them to the lab for analysis.
Okay, now once we've determined the field, we've got it marked off, what's our orange stick for?
Okay, first of all, we have X amount of paces at the starting edge of the field, and then we go X amount of paces along the edge of the field, and then we go X amount of paces into the field, and that's where we use our tine to measure where these two rows are going to be. And this represents, these two rows, two units in this field, represent the soybeans in one of the samples in the state of Kansas. We're not trying to establish what this field is yielding, but at random we are selecting these two spaces as to the state of Kansas and the United States.
Now, when you say X amount of paces, is X determined by the size of the field?
True, it is, and it's done at random, and wherever those paces take you, so be it.
Okay, so I mean, you could end up in a good patch or a bad patch.
Absolutely, that's the important part of this thing, is that an enumerator doesn't try to pick out the best spot in the field or the poorest spot or whatever. It is wherever it is, it is. And that's what represents the soybean yield.
Now, but in this field, you'll do multiple locations.
Two units.
So you kind of get a decent average. You may have one poor area and one good area.
Very, very well could be, yeah. You bet.
And so again, the importance of having farmers participate in this, because we want to make sure that they understand this isn't to determine a good field or a bad field.
Absolutely.
We're just trying to get information to the USDA.
Exactly. We're trying to establish, because of the randomness, we're able to on an average, find out what the yields of soybeans are going to be.
And time frame, when do you start this and when do you end it?
Okay, we start the end of July, and we go up right until just a few days before harvest.
So pretty much the heat of the summer.
Absolutely, yes indeed. I've spent a lot of days out there in 100 degree weather.
Yeah. Well, again, Bill, thank you for your time. And again, if you're approached about doing this, guys, let them in your field. Again, they're not there to determine if you've got a good field or a bad field. We're just trying to get accurate information out of the state of Kansas.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Thank you for your time.